Hello, my fierce art family. So for today's video, we are going to talk about the Aquarius Violet and the new colors that Roman Szmal have released. They gave us a teaser on their social media. I got the information on Facebook. So I decided to go ahead and swatch this Aquarius Violet that I got on my recent trip to Poland and compare it with the other interesting violets and other beautiful colors that is nice to compare with it from the Roman Szmal Aquarius range. I'm also going to do a review of this brush that I recently got on my haul, and I did a sample painting and then some watercolor tests. So without further ado, let's get started. So 2 days ago, September 3, 2023, Roman Szmal Art have posted on their social media, and I got this on Facebook, and they say, "We are pleased to introduce another 20 new colors of our paints, including 16 monopigment ones and the legendary plum Aquarius Violet." And that's not our final say. We will be selling these soon. And here are the 20 new colors from the Aquarius Extra Fine Watercolors line. So we are starting off with a Nickel Tungsten Yellow PY189, Azo Yellow PY128, Anthraquinone Yellow PY147, Gamboge Hue PY95, Bismuth Orange PO86, Raspberry Red PR272, Quinacridone Warm Scarlet PR207, Perylene Vermilion PR123, Perylene Scarlet PR149, Perylene Red Deep PR179, and then Strontium Violet PV62, Aquarius Violet PB29, PV19, PR255, Phthalo Blue, Turquoise Shade, it's a PB15:4, Royal Blue Light is PBW6, PB29, and PB15:1. A limited edition Lapis Lazuli Afghan, and it's an Earth Pigment, Natural Umber Reddish, PBR7 Earth Pigment, Benzimidazole Brown, PBR25, Urban Gray, 4 pigments, PW6:1, PBR29, PB29, and PY150, Graphite, PBK10, and Velvet Black, PR264, PG7. So those are the beautiful colors, and I'm so happy to announce to you that today we are going to talk about Aquarius Violet. So let's get swatching. And here I have the Aquarius Violet, and I saw from the comments on Roman Szmal post that this is the color that everybody is mostly excited about, and I am too. So finally, I have an excuse to swatch this one and share it with you. Also, I've been meaning to do this, but I was just very busy with some exhibitions that happened the previous weekend and so much more. The brush that we're going to use today is this one, and it is one of the brushes that I have on my super huge haul from the Roman Szmal store in Krakow, Poland. This is from the Black Pearl series and recommended by Roman Szmal himself. I have the size 9, and this brush is made of a mixture of synthetic and natural bristles. So today we get to test this brush also. I placed the full pan inside the refrigerator so it's easy for us to unwrap it. And while it's there, I am going to talk about the pigments that is in the Aquarius Violet, starting with PB29. There are 4 colors that are with a pigment of PB29 on the Aquarius line. That's the Ultramarine Light, Ultramarine Blue, Ultramarine Intense, and the French Ultramarine. All of them has excellent light fast. They are staining, granulating, and semi-transparent. For the next pigment, PV19, there are 2 on the Roman Szmal Aquarius range. It's the Quinacridone Violet and Quinacridone Red. Both are excellent in the light pass. Both are staining, non-granulating, and pretty much transparent. And lastly, we have PR255, and I found one which is Pyro Scarlet, has excellent light fast, heavily staining, non-granulating, and semi-transparent. So those are the three pigments, and those are the other colors that are having the single pigment on the Roman Szmal Aquarius line. Now we can unwrap this candy. I am super excited. All right, so if you notice, I only have the wrapper, unlike when you buy the full pens, it usually comes with an extra watercolor paper and there is a swatch on top. But this is how it was given to me because it was pretty new when I was there. And right, so that's the wrapper, and then there is an extra paper film on the top right here. Okay, so this is one of those colors that are a little bit too sticky, so I think I have to put it back a little bit more so we do not waste the pigment and it's easy to lift from this paper. And now I am back after about like 5 minutes, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, so now it's much more easier to remove this paper, as you see. So all you have to do, just remember that, don't be so frustrated. Just put it on the refrigerator for a few minutes. If you are in a hurry, put it on the freezer for a few minutes. And then you can easily lift that paper on top of it. And now we are ready to swatch. By the way, the paper that we're using today is 100% cotton. Starting off with just swatching all of it, like checking the mastone. So now you make it wet. Okay. Oh, beautiful. I have too much water, but yeah. All right. Wow. You really could see the color separation. That is so beautiful. Oh my God. And they even say legendary. And now I think I know why. This is super beautiful. Oh my goodness. I can see the PP29 peek through there, the PB19. PR25 is so subtle, so I don't see so much of a red orange, at least for this swatch. Maybe on the dry down we can see it. So yeah. Oh wow. I cannot stop just like swatching and playing with it. All right, so it's a good thing that I started with this one so we can easily see how it is as it dries. So that's the first swatch that we're doing, and then I am going to do the next swatch on this butterfly so we see the transparency also. Okay, so starting with like a little bit darker and then it fades at the bottom. I really love the movement. I really like the movement of this one. It's just so stunning. So I will be comparing it to several of Roman Szmal watercolors that we are already loving. We have the Shadow Violet, the Prszybysz Gray, a Mineral Violet. And I wanted to also compare it with the other violets on his line, like the Dioxazine Violet. We also have Manganese Violet. I'm gonna compare it with Misty Morning also because we just want to check it out. And the Lavender. Okay. So that's how we have it. So nice. Okay, can we make it move a little bit more? Okay, let me just add a teeny bit more water. Okay. So now you see that that is almost dry. Okay. All right. Maybe I just add a teeny bit more over here. Now it covered up the top part of this butterfly illustration. My water is currently blue violet now. Let's just see if we can lift a little bit from here. Yes, we can. Okay, wow. I really like how it stains the paper, but you can see that we can still lift it, but there is still some staining in there. So I'm just gonna do a wet on wet over here. We check how beautiful the movement is and how it disperses. That is so beautiful. Oh my goodness. Oh wow. Like intergalactic also. Maybe I try to check how it reacts with salt. Our favorite way of testing the watercolor. Okay, I put quite a lot in there. Maybe we can make a little bit of some lines. And then a dry brush. Let's see how it's gonna be. Let me just make sure that my brush is a little bit more dry. Okay, so I grab a little bit of the pigment here. Here we go. Look at how beautiful this dries. Oh my god, that is so nice. I can already imagine painting a nightscape with this one. Maybe we can do a dry on dry. So I just put that here instead. Then I wait for this to dry and then go over it again. Now this is after a few minutes, and then we go over it. All right, so there you go. And I think we can go do a test of making a painting out of just this one color, since it has three pigments, beautiful pigments. You see the separation. We see the diffused part over here, mass tone, the lifting is so beautiful. The dry brush is nice. We have a line that I did a little bit too thick. The salt part, you can see that in a little bit. Wet on wet is still like a very beautiful galactic round thing in there. So nice. And yeah, we can go do a sample painting. All right, so now Let's do some painting, shall we? Did you see how this one looks like? It's so beautiful. Okay, let's just reactivate this one then. And use this one. Maybe I start in the middle. Okay, lots of water needed. Okay. So I feel like I wanted a lot of color in the body of the vase. And then just put some salt afterwards. Maybe we'll leave a tiny bit of white space. Then I make this part super dark. Adding more color here. And then now we'll just add a pinch of salt. I think that should be enough. And then a little bit of some wet on wet. So lots of water, and if I actually really wanted to do a little bit of dispersion also, so I touch a little bit on the end over here, and I'm also going to need to fix that a teeny bit later on. So we're going to apply all of this test that we had earlier on this painting. Yeah, I think I should leave the bottom alone. All right, and then a little bit color, just a teeny bit. This color is just so magical. Applying some more water. With a bit more pigment. And then I'm going to need a little bit of drying time. But maybe I can do a little bit of some lines. Okay. Just so you know, we are actually painting in real time. There's no editing that will be happening, so if it's a little bit too long and boring, my apologies. apologies. I'm also like enjoying the color. And how it flows. Just the magic in general that it can do. Does it really hold on its legendary claim? We would find out once this painting is dry. Maybe I need a little bit more water. It's like a dry brush now. Okay, maybe just make this fade a little bit like so. And same thing on this part. Well, this part should be wet on wet as well. So I'm adding water for the background. I'm okay with that dispersing, not a problem. That's what I wanted it to be anyway. All right, so maybe add a teeny bit more pigment in there. And then some dry brush for the bottom of the vase. My brush is not so dry. But yeah, I can just do like this for now, and then I can apply a little bit more dry brushing later on. Maybe fix this a little bit. A little bit of some lifting. A little bit more of the dry brush effect over here. Our base, the base of the vase. I have some stuck in here, just help them move a little bit. And there too. I feel like I wanted to add a little bit more. Now that it is drying. Basically just playing with this color here. Put a little bit more shape back to our vase. Oh, I really hope that you are not bored. By the way, if you make it up to the end of this video, I would like to know which one of the 20 new Roman Szmal colors are you more interested about? Are you like me, who's much more excited about the Aquarius Violet? Or do you have other colors that catches your attention and that you are more excited to use? So while I wait for this to dry, maybe we can remove the salt from our salt test. Oh, it's stuck on there too much now. Oh, goodness me. You hear that sound? Sandpaper sound, sorry. Okay. But what I noticed is that the PB29 is collected more on the part where the salt was. And then now we can see a little bit of the PR255 surrounding it. Looking back at our intergalactic part, look at how it dries down. So interesting. I'm just really fascinated about how this swatch went. It was so stunning. I am going to, once everything is dry, I'm going to insert a shot of this entire paper on natural light or like a different types of light that I can find at home. As we wait for the magic to happen here on our rustic flower vase, I am now going to proceed on this part that I really find exciting. Well, it's gonna be the first time that I'm doing this. So if you like this type of videos, if you have a request of colors that you like, because I pretty much have all of the Roman Szmal watercolors. And if you watch my watercolor collection, you know which watercolors I have. So maybe we can do something like this also. Yeah, so first one that I wanted to compare it with is, of course, Shadow Violet. And that Shadow Violet, I have it on my Christoph Ludwig's palette, the 36 watercolors from Roman Szmal, which is on this packaging. So I label my pens like so, the number from Roman Szmal, the name, and then the information about light phases and so on, and then the pigment. So for this one, we have two pigments that are the same, which is PB29 and PV19. So that's why I really wanted to compare this one with our Aquarius Violet. All right, so let's go do some swatching, shall we? All right, I did not pre-wet this one. So as you see, it's like added the water right away in there. And then we are going to swatch it on the first one on the top. Shadow Violet. And we'll just add a little bit more here on the top. And I move on to the next one. The next one that I think was close is Prszybysz Gray. Prszybysz Gray also have PB29, but it has PR177 and PG26. This is a super beautiful gray, very unique to Roman Szmal's Aquarius line. It's one of my favorite colors from the entire Roman Szmal watercolor range. It's just so beautiful. Maybe I can do a painting of just like using this color as well. And add a little bit more here on the top. Next, we have here Mineral Violet, which has two of the same pigments, PB29 and PV19. Also, such a beautiful, beautiful color. The Let me just do a little bit more over here. All right. Now from my Mona Omrani set, I will grab Dioxazine Violet. We only have BV37 for this one. There's absolutely nothing similar, just the word violet. All right, so let's just still swatch that one. Would be interesting to compare. I would love to swatch all of the Roman Szmal Violets, but I actually have not yet opened the other ones. Maybe we do it some other time. If you're interested, let me know in the comment section down below if you wanted to see all of the Roman Szmal Violets or any other color from the Roman Szmal range. This is so nice too. Very different. There you go. Next, another violet, we have Manganese Violet, and it's PV16. More pink leaning violet. So the Dioxazine Violet has more blue in it, and this one has more red in it. I'm sorry if this video could be so long. It's just like so much fun to swatch colors, and I know that you know what I mean. It's like we are just on this swatch universe and we don't want to leave. It's a happy place. All right, so there you go. And then we have just two more left. One of the most popular watercolors for Roman Szmal, that's a Misty Morning. Here it is, and it has PG50 and PV19, 7 light fast, medium staining, granulating, and semi-transparent. All right, so let's go ahead and swatch this beauty. One of the most exciting colors from Roman Szmal, everybody's favorite. And I actually get to ask Mr. Roman Szmal, what is the inspiration behind Misty Morning? And then he said, could be a one fine foggy day. Or the artist that he have spoken to is requesting or is needing a color that represents the fog of the morning. So those were the ones that he mentioned when I met him personally, when I was in Krakow, Poland. Such a very, very nice man, super kind-hearted. And I will also soon go ahead and share to you my super huge Roman Szmal haul from Krakow, Poland, with a lot of the stuff that Mr. Szmal himself have recommended and have given me. He is super nice. All right, so that's the Misty Morning. And last but not the least is the Lavenda, which has PW5, BB29, and PV16. All right, the last color. Let's swatch it. So all of the colors that we swatch and compare with Aquarius Violet today, I did not pre-wet them. I just wet them the moment that I am going to swatch them, like so. But, all of these Aquarius watercolors are easy to re-wet anyway, so that's not a problem at all. This has a lot of PW5 showing through. Yeah, nonetheless, still a beautiful color. All right, now we have done all the swatches. Should we go back to my painting? So among all of the colors that we swatched today to compare with it, nothing is close enough. All of them are quite different, which is a good thing. So if you have any of these colors and you wanted to compare it with the shadow violet, or you are looking for a specific type of a violet to add to your collection, then at least you have an idea from the things that we have swatched and compare with today. All right, so I am just gonna go back to my painting right here. Perhaps I can go ahead and lift it. Okay, so we can remove the salt. Yeah, same as how we tested it earlier. When we remove the salt, where the salt was, is a little bit more bluish, which is our PB29, same as how I could see it here on our test, which is quite good. Look at that effect. This is so beautiful. I don't even think I need to edit this painting anymore, or perhaps there's a little bit of some dry brush effect, since we would love to go ahead and add that, since we did some test about that. So probably the shadows over here. You will see that a lot of my paintings, I had like some shadows at the bottom. All right, so a little bit darker perhaps. Okay. But you can see the color, the background as it dries down. We had a wet on wet technique over there. Super beautiful. And then this fade effect over here is just so stunning. Our line here is just beautiful. I mean, I'm describing my own painting, sorry about that. But yeah, let me know what you think about it on the comment section down below, of course. And yeah, maybe I just wanted to add just a teeny bit over here. Maybe some dry brush effect. Sometimes I wanted some dry brushing over here. Okay, that's not super dry, but yeah, well, all right there. Maybe a little bit over here. And here also. Adding a little bit more depth and character to it. And I think that's it. It's beautiful as is. All right, so there you go. I hope that you enjoyed this one as much as I enjoyed this watching. I got a little bit overboard. It was a super long video. I initially just planned to show that to you, do a bit of swatching, and then I realized, let me go ahead and compare it to the other interesting colors on my collection. Some that has purple, or like the ones that has the pigments that is incorporated on this particular color, the Aquarius Violet. Yeah, so excited for this color. And if you are watching this and you are thinking of grabbing this one, then yeah, let me know in the comment section down below. Let's talk about this color and your favorite Roman Szmal watercolors. As for my initial reaction, first impressions about this beautiful brush, the Black Pearl Roman Szmal number 9. I really like it. I love this handle. I love the black, and we have like the pearlized transparent coating in there. This brass metal in gold color is also quite a nice touch. In the beginning, I had a hard time because when I was like trying to wet this one, it was not going back to this point. It was not snappy right away, but that is because there is some gum arabic at the tip. But as I was painting with it, as the swatching goes along, then it becomes better and better. And as you see, the point is very nice. So even if like right now I dip it into water, like just right now, I'm just like show that to you so you see. And then if I remove a little bit of the excess water, you see that it goes back to the point and it is quite nice. And yeah, I love it. I love how this swatches, and I love the painting that I made using this brush. Right, so don't forget to check out my other videos. I have quite a lot here, and if you have any video requests, let me know. Follow me on social media. I have the Fierce Art everywhere, and I actually do have two Instagrams, so go ahead and check it out. The link will be on the About section of my YouTube channel. And if you're subscribed, thank you very much for being a part of my journey from the beginning. If you are not yet, please go ahead and do so. If you give this video a like because you wanted to, it will make me happy, and then it will help my channel. And especially if you share this video, that's gonna make my channel grow. So thank you very much in advance. I also post on the community tab here on YouTube, so we can talk there if I wanted to give you a sneak peek or some advanced preview of some things that I will be uploading, then it will be there. So let's talk there. And I always reply to all of your comments. I love to talk to you guys. So yeah, I love to see your comments. So I will see you there and see you on my next video. I love you all, my Fierce Art family. This is Elizabeth, and see ya.